Hello and welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala. I am Anushree Nagpal from the Department of Geography, Jamia Millia Islamia. I am presenting this module on behalf of Kulsum Fatima. In this episode, we shall learn about the urban morphology of Chandigarh. The learning objectives are, first, to understand and study the impacts and implications of environmental elements towards settlement planning and the relevance of geographical features. Second, to understand the importance of their formation and transformation in spatial character of the settlement area. Introduction. The city has its prehistoric past dating as back as 8,000 years and is known to be home to the ancient Harappan civilization, while deriving its name from the temple of goddess of power called Chandi and as a fort lying next to the temple called Garh. This area falls under the earlier prosperous province of Punjab, which was divided into East and West Punjab during the partition of 1947. It was initially conceived as the capital of East Punjab in India and has been effective in accommodating refugees uprooted from West Punjab to get resettled. This led to the initialization of urban development of the city, starting as early as 1950, which eventually made it one of the fastest growing cities in India and later getting declared as a union territory in 1966 to serve as a capital to both the states of Punjab and Haryana. The city serves as a regional and political center for its adjoining states, while being one of the greenest cities in India, as it has a unique planning concept known as City Beautiful Movement. The then Indian Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru envisioned Chandigarh city as a symbol of the nation's faith in the future, free from the traditions of the past. Therefore, its design and construction was a matter of national importance as a national ideal. The city was developed as a symbol for India's modernity and idealism. European architect Le Corbusier was invited to plan the city that was famous for his approaches in architectural modernism. City morphology. Geological setting. Geologically, Chandigarh city is located at the first front of the plain containing the alluvial deposits originating from the erosion hills of Himalayan mountains called Shivalik hill ranges. These hill ranges are created by the Himalayan runoff and further broken down by the intermittent river sources to get transformed into the fertile plains of Punjab and Haryana. These plains have always been inhabited since the last 4,000 years owing to its fertile quality and proximity with the Shivalik foothills. The northern periphery of Shivalik hills and the upstream river courses support the agricultural economies in these areas by utilizing their available ecological cycles. Geographical setting. Unlike Himalayan ranges, the Shivalik hills are created by the local runoff of the Himalayan rivers and their tributaries, including Ghaggar and Satluj, which bring down the alluvium deposits from Himalayan ranges, which are further broken down and converted into the fertile alluvial plain, which contains Chandigarh site. The Himalayan mountain ranges end towards the north of Chandigarh site, leading the Ghaggar River to drain while crossing the plains towards the east of Chandigarh site. It's the Ghaggar River after which the diminutive Shivalik hill ranges exist while providing peripheral edges to the city. The original city site was placed over the inclined plain along the Shivalik hills in the backdrop to utilize the action of intermittent rivers in slicing and converting the hills into the alluvial plains where the city was planned to be located. The site is further described being located at an ideal 2-degree slope with respect to the foothills, which is considered good for drainage purposes. Architect Le Corbusier's original plan incorporated a lot of green zones within the city, dedicated towards the direction of the site drainage slope and expected to utilize the site's natural irrigated landscape. Hydrological setting. Surface water sources. The presence of Shivalik hills on the northern periphery of Chandigarh site affects its hydrology in totality and its ground conditions. River Ghaggar and its tributaries along with River Satluj are known for contributing water sources to the city before getting merged into larger rivers. Owing to the geographical setting of the site, no major natural surface water body exists within Chandigarh except for small ponds in few of the rural areas. As shown in the figure, the blue line indicative of areas natural hydrology is the conceptual boundary for Chandigarh as suggested by Le Corbusier's protective vision. The city has its natural drainage dependent on two major stream sources, locally known as Sukhna Ko and Patiala Ki Rao. The Sukhna Ko flows from north to south direction to drain the eastern part and joins the Ghagar River. This Ko has been dammed in the northeastern periphery of the city to create the largest man-made lake of India known as the Sukhna Lake with a water holding capacity of 5 million cubic meters. This was further diverted to make a single stream water channel diverted towards southeast direction of Ambala as shown in the figure. The Patiala Ki Rao flows northeast to southwest and drains the northern part of the city. Both these streams are ephemeral in nature and carry high flows during monsoon. Another Ko originating from sector 31 and drains southernmost parts of the city. Groundwater sources. Due to the lithological conditions, the groundwater aquifers are restricted in the southern part of the city. The rest of the city has groundwater aquifers confined as well as semi-confined conditions. Confined aquifers exist near sectors 10, 33, 38 and 47, while leaky are encountered around sector 28. Central parts of the city along with sectors including 10, 12 and 31 are known for having shallow aquifers. As per the pumping data available, the maximum decline in groundwater level is of 16 meters in sector 10, 10 meters decline in sector 31, and the remaining city decline ranges between 5 to 8 meters. This decline is attributed to the practice of overpumping and extraction in the central shallow aquifers, which was banned earlier. Physiographic setting. Majorly, three sand beds exist along Sukhna Ko with a varying percentage of clay from 30% to 62%, while sand percentage varying from 38% to 70%. In general, the soils of Chandigarh city plains exhibit light yellowish brown to pale brown color containing kunkar. It's calcareous in nature and is deficient in nitrogen, phosphorus and potash. Whereas the soils belonging to the floodplains affected by seasonal rivulets carry a variable texture which is coarse and stratified, having irregular distribution of depth as they are regularly drained. The city has four physiographic units starting with the northeastern boundary of city having deep plains which are excessively drained with erosion ranging from slight to moderate as an impact of Shivalik range. Alluvial fans formed on southwestern slopes of the foothills. Northern part bearing soil, which is sandy to sandy loam in nature, whereas it is loamy to silty loam in southern parts of the city. Regional level soil characteristics. The most prominent deformation known as Chandigarh fault is observed to the right bank of the river Ghagar and is nearly about 5 kilometers southeast of Chandigarh. According to its geographic location, there is a concentration of active faults near populated areas of Chandigarh city along with other nearby small towns and villages, making them fall under zones of high seismic hazard and the active faults, while the biggest threat in case of large magnitude of earthquake. City level soil characteristics. The seismotectonic status of the area reveals that Chandigarh is broadly associated with seismic intensity of 8 on MSK scale and has been categorized in high hazard zone. As per the geotechnical tests, the strata of Chandigarh is classified into class D stiff soil of the NEHRP code of provisions, leading to the possibilities of liquefaction in the northwestern, western, central and southwestern parts of Chandigarh where groundwater exists at shallow depths including sectors 15 to 17, 22 to 25, 32 to 39, etc. The western part of Chandigarh, Mohali, Jagatpura, sectors 47 to 51, 15, 38, Kaimbwala, etc., show the maximum damage potential, whereas the eastern part, including Panchkula, fall in the minimum damage potential zone on comparative terms. The residual intensity map indicates that the lowest vulnerable areas are Mansa Devi complex, Mani Majra, etc. The maximum intensity increment is expected in localities such as Jagatpura, sectors 47 to 51, 38, etc. However, as per the predominant frequency map, it is suggested that short-heighted structures are likely to get less affected and is relatively safer as compared to the taller structures, particularly of 10 or higher stories, which are expected to experience much greater resonance and therefore are likely to get maximum damage under the influence of large earthquakes. Chandigarh city planning. The city has been divided into four major zones based on the four functions of living, working, care of the body and spirit, and circulation, leading to the zones of residential sectors, work-related sectors, leisure, green areas and circulation systems. Le Corbusier conceived the master plan of Chandigarh city as analogous to human body with a clearly defined head, which makes sector 1 carrying the famous capital complex, consisting of the secretariat building, the high court building and the legislative assembly, considered as architectural masterpieces globally. Within this capital complex stands giant metallic structures of the open hand, which is the official emblem signifying city's philosophy of open to give and open to receive. Followed by sector 17 catering to its commercial activities as the heart of the city. The leisure valley, innumerable open spaces and sector green areas are designated lung spaces, while the intellect spaces included the cultural and educational institutions consisting of Postgraduate Institute, Punjab Engineering College and Punjab University, etc. Chandigarh also has devised its own unique concept of 7 V's, which formulated its circulation and road network. The 7 V's are V1, regional highways, V2, connecting V1, V3, grid pattern of the city, V4, bisecting the sector, V5, loop road, intersecting V4, V6, access to doors of the residence, V7, pedestrian. The sector placement. The city's structure was governed by the road system since phase 1 planning. The road network supported the grid planning for the city while ensuring effective transportation and easy laying of infrastructures along the roadside, including drainage, storm lines, water lines, etc. Each sector was planned to have 4 entry points with V4 type of road, while type V2 and V3 roads encloses the sector. These sectors were laid in the direction of site slope while being oriented towards northwest and southeast direction to ensure proper ventilation and natural cleaning of streets through air movement. Sector size. Based on the concept of walkability, the easy walkable distance, which is 200 to 400 meters, is used to establish the grid using its multiple dimensions, making it 800 meters into 1200 meters with bus stops at every 400 meter. This 400 meter distance is also considered good for humans to be able to visualize, appreciate and memorize their surroundings, and therefore the sector size was freezed at 400 meter distance. This made all amenities within the sector reachable within 10 minutes of walking distance. These sectors carried a self-confined characteristic as self-sufficient neighborhoods for community living, including market, places of worship, schools, etc. within easy reach. These sectors were expected to cater to a population range between 5,000 to 35,000 during the initial phases. However, during the later stages, the north sectors became less densely populated as compared to the southern sectors within the city, leading to differentiated uses and settlement types. As per the residential typology, the settlements are identified as planned and unplanned settlements, whereas the housing typology is categorized as the following. Public. Government employees and institutional housing. Private. individual plots purchased from the Chandigarh administration and the ones built by Chandigarh Housing Board. Urban developments in Chandigarh city. The city has always been in demand due to its dual association with the states of Punjab and Haryana as the focus of the political center, affecting socio-economic quality of life. The city also has pressures of being a pioneer in city planning and design in India, and therefore has been an all-time favorite of the population for migration in search of better services and quality of life. Due to urbanization, it's expanding at an unprecedented pace with the thriving pressure of being able to expand as well as to be able to retain its elegant past. This demands a careful transformation of existing natural and built environment. Urban demography. The city of Chandigarh was planned in two different phases for a population of 500,000. In phase 1, 36 square kilometer of land was considered for development of 30 sectors. Whereas during the phase 2 of planning, additional land was acquired by the Chandigarh administration for 17 additional sectors, sector 31 to 47, to cater for a population of up to 3,50,000. The second phase of development was intended towards high density of population, leading to the presence of predominant 3-4 story apartments for accommodating high population. However, Chandigarh city has now grown beyond its planned capacity and premises, and therefore its phase 3 for planning and development is proposed in areas from sector 48 onwards. The phase wise growth is depicted in the figure showing the development footprint at the beginning up to year 1956, 1955 to 66, development of phase 1 sectors 1966 to 1976 indicating phase 1 sectors, and the extensions of phase 2 sectors from 1976 to 86, development footprints of phase 2 sectors, and lastly from 1986 to 96 showing the emerging scenario of urban footprints. Urban green cover. The city of Chandigarh has a total of 3,245 hectares of area under forest, and most of it is hilly. There are mostly around Sukhna Lake, Sukhna Ko and Patiala Ki Rao. These forest areas are mostly hilly in nature, and towards the outskirts of city near village Kansal, there is a reserve forest area with restricted entry. Chandigarh has urban green area dedicated at two levels. City level, as shown in figure, the hierarchy of green cover is allocated at various levels within Chandigarh city plan, starting from regional level interventions with wetlands, as shown in the location number. Leisure valley and special gardens and similar spaces exist as city level interventions shown in the figure, followed by the central green areas allocated in each sector as sector level intervention, whereas at community level, green cover consists of parks around which clusters of houses are arranged, as shown in the location number in the figure. Further, the smallest category of green space is the courtyards available with each residential unit, as its front and rear backyard side shown in the location number in the figure. Neighborhood level. The green cover at neighborhoods level is shown in the figure, where current green cover and existing land uses are clearly shown with distinction between the grid pattern based layout of Chandigarh and its natural adjacencies. These adjacent areas are organic in pattern as a result of the past agricultural practices and recent economic development opportunism. This transformation is an inevitable process of urbanization, which is causing development in peripheral areas characterized as a semi-urban or peri-urban edge. Urban growth timeline. The master plan of Chandigarh was conceived as early as 1951 and advocated the earliest development during the phase 1 building, the roads and layout service infrastructure, where south side got low density development, whereas the north side has high density accompanied by intermediate densities from rural sprawl. Later in 1956, ministers' bungalow, nursery schools and capital complex, town hall and state library, sector 17, Polytechnic for Men, Sector 26, Gandhi Bhavan, Sector 14 and Administration Building, Sector 14 and the addition of many more social amenities with most residential areas were executed. The year 1956 marked the completion of the construction for Phase 1 development. Later, SAS Nagar was added to its periphery in the alignment with Chandigarh's existing layout, and as a consequence, the state of Haryana added Panchkula city towards the east of Chandigarh along its entry routes, and it became dependent on Chandigarh for its services. As shown in figure, Chandigarh growth timeline showing the congestion in the industrial area and unauthorized constructions in 1971 onwards. 1991 onwards, the increase in population led to urban sprawl surpassing Chandigarh's boundary through Panchkula area. In order to cater to the urban sprawl, Chandigarh's extension started in different directions, with Mohali and Panchkula being the preferred destinations, offering close connectivity with the main city. These places are not only near to the main city but have a very good connectivity. So it witnessed the rapid growth in Mohali and nearby areas. It also houses more migration because of its capacity to absorb the migrated people and informal sectors which support the city. Chandigarh being overcrowded, the need of other city extensions are felt to accommodate its urban sprawl. The settlement on its periphery are also taking place as a rehabilitated colonies made by government for urban poor, leading to the encroachment of city's green areas, with townships of Panchkula, Mohali, Mansa Devi and Zirakpur coming up in the past 3 decades. The original concept of having a green periphery as per the master plan legislation of peripheral control also stands diminished. Among all land area available around the city, most of them have a higher commercial value as compared to agricultural land, and therefore are likely to get misused for commercial activities with haphazard growth, spoiling the natural features of the area. Within the past 60 years, the pressures of growth and depleting resources with extensive immigration and urban sprawl have been creating new settlement areas and are credited for the formation of Tri-City called Chandigarh, Mohali and the Panchkula. Thank you.